Who am I? Who am I? That was from Zoolander. Remember Zoolander? Who am I? I'm your Uncle Lance.
James, interview.
I like it.
The cosplaying thing started about 5 years ago. Actually, longer than that, because I made a Darth Vader costume, and then I modified it, and that looks really cool. And then I joined the San Diego Star Wars Society about 5 years ago. People don't necessarily have to dress up, or, you know, they can share their love of the Star Wars comic books or the novels or just the fandom of it. You don't necessarily have to dress up. It's not necessarily a costume club. I like dressing up because in doing the volunteering, because I think it's fun. When I first joined, I did to do the volunteer work. I wanted to do stuff for like Children's Hospital. I wanted to do stuff for Make-A-Wish. Just like little gift things that the kids get, and it takes their mind off of why they're there. The last one that we did for the Last Jedi and for the theater in Mira Mesa, that was a Make-A-Wish thing. The family, the child, he wanted to fight Darth Vader. And I was just like, oh my gosh, because they could ask for any wish they want. They could ask to go to Disneyland with his family and all that stuff like that. And all this little boy wanted was to fight Darth Vader. And I was just like blown away by that. You know, I mean, he could ask for anything. He would have fight Darth Vader. So that got the feels right here, you know, because, yeah. The volunteering stuff, the charity stuff, that's why I joined. And then you have the fun stuff, like just marching in parades. I did two holiday parades, and I always fall behind because you get swept up in all the people that are lining the parade routes. You know, you want to shake everybody's hands, and you want to fist bump everybody, and you want to take and you can't. You just get lost in it because you have no peripheral vision. All you see is straight ahead of you, and you just see all the families like, hey, and da-da-da. Ideally, you want to just keep going and not take any pictures because you fall behind. I was at the end of our block. You know, but those were one of those events where like, yeah, you get a kick out of it because all the Star Wars nerds come out. On the parade route, yeah. I used to volunteer at Children's Hospital like twice a week to do like playroom visits and stuff like that and bedside visits. And I would just literally play ball with them or play games with them and stuff like that. And that ripped my heart out just because some of those kids in there are like really bad shape, health wise and all that. So volunteerism, I highly recommend everybody does it. You get a certain satisfaction of knowing you've done something that brightened somebody's life, you know, whether it's kids or their family or yeah. I always tell people this. You're lucky you're healthy. You're lucky your kids are healthy. Because some of the stuff that I saw when I volunteered there the first time, you see a little baby suffering from, who has cancer. And they're going through chemotherapy and stuff like that. It just, it makes you wonder why. Why is this 4-year-old, and that was one of the things that just tore me up inside. I was like, because, you know, you go through training before you volunteer. I don't know how they do it now, but when I volunteered, you had to go through training. You had to know what not to say to the kids. And basically, you didn't say anything to the kids. You know, because I had this happen several times where, like,
they wanted to know why they were hurting and why they had to be there and, you know, what they did wrong. And it was like, you didn't do anything wrong. Those were the kind of things that's just like, oh, yeah. So bringing a little joy to people's lives, it's, yeah, it's really satisfying. We did a event at Ultra Star Cinemas, but I'm standing there and I see like these two guys. They look like Navy SEALs. They were just like guns. They look like they were chiseled out of granite. The guy comes up to me and goes, "Hey, can I get a picture with you?" And I go, "Sure." And they just turn into like nerds. They're like, "Oh my God, I love your costume, dude. You look awesome." And the alpha male thing disappears. They turn into like 10-year-old kids. So he's in front of me, I do a chokehold on him. Then, you know, you see Vader over his shoulder and he's like, ah. I mean, that's basically it.